At least for the third map, I would stick to something more common. Psyche is known to be a recon. BK is known to be an assault. I know that RTJ plays a lot of support, I can confirm this as well, but you know, stick to the basics this time. Don't try stuff out. Go for something you're good at. You know that you're good at. I'm not saying they're bad at the others, but they're not as good at as they probably are in the other role. Safe to say. Besides Psyche. Psyche's a very good assault from what we can see with this very aggressive bunny hop assault.
The roles on either team are back to being the same. Tentacle with a Super 7. Not gonna swap it out with Moogie though, which is surprising.
Now, Worst MT is back in the disadvantage for the ping here, so maybe that could be a very vital factor. Who knows?
Tentacle smoking off left side.
So we got NSF completely on the bottom lane, whereas BK is chilling out at the vent at the top. Who knows what he might make out of this, especially now that they're, you know, outnumbered.
Oh, Moogie taking some hits.
BK is falling back, he's going for the elevator drop here.
Oh.
Oh man, very thrilling engagement. Both of them backing off, losing a lot of health in the progress. Process, not progress. Ooh!
Gets the drop on Moogie.
That was very bad timing for him to pick up the ghost.
BK's on the flank.
He only has 7 HP and he has to face a wall of meat of 200 HP, especially now capping the ghost or trying to go for it.
Oh, now you're strapped with the last kill on BK.
He got a fair amount of damage in given a situation, but it was so unlikely he would have been able to pull something here.
Looks like
So
Epsilon.
they
Looks like
kicked it
Epsilon.
off here. They got the lead. They also got a corporal right from the start again. Scriber being the corporal in this case, which is very strong for the assault.
Moogie with the Super 7 this time. Very interesting to see how this will play out.
I'm just hoping, I'm really just hoping from the bottom of my heart that Worst NT will put out on the sign that will make BK realize it's not working out as recon. I have to go assault. Literally everyone is waiting for this.
Moogie watching those stairs.
Also, Suna, people have been saying that the game keeps kind of freezing if you tap out. If you're tabbing out, like.
Oh, Moogie's got the drop on RTJ, who's going for the ghost. BK gets the frag on Scryber.
We're on this even situation. In this case, they have no support on Skanks, so no way to counter smokes. Psyche takes care of the recon here, so now all Tentacle has to rely on is the smokes if he has any. Just trying to pick him off with the SRM. I don't think the SRM was the wisest choice to take the top pass here. So, for those interested, it seems that the Twitch stream is actively broadcasting the communication of Worst NT's team, as I've been briefly hearing in the background of mine. So, you should maybe check that out.
Very interesting to see the levels of communication that are going on here. It's like he gets the first frag on Scriber, making it uneven.
Psyche's going back to his very aggressive pushes here. Seems like, yep, he's just directly facing Moogie, taking him out. RTJ would have been there to help. They're going back to, you know, sticking together, being one unit. Psyche doing the aggressive cleanup. BK just, I don't know why, being very passive with his recon plays. So they're sort of circling around the ghosts. Tentacle just chilling at spawn. I think that is the wisest decision. So, if Psyche still has his grenade, that's the worst thing he can do. One grenade in there, he needs dead meat. Psyche's just going up.
Oh, BK's down.
Chasing him. Tentacles down to... Oh, okay. Zero here. Very interesting attempt, you know, smoking yourself in, but... I don't think it's the best idea, even in the spawn point, because there's only two options. You're hiding around the corner, you're hiding in the smoke. People will, you know, pre-fire the smoke. So, I don't think much hesitation would have been involved in here. The lineups remain the same. BK is very persistent about his recon spot.
No weapon swaps on NSF. I think that's for the better, though.
Both teams are not that fast. Ooh. Psyche being the only link. Never mind. They're actually all pushing in at once now.
Oh.
Just meat grinding themselves into the corner. I seem to jinx the passive play a lot.
Oh, is Moogie gonna get the spike? Yes, he is.
Jay, he was sitting on full health there, being the support. He had the advantage of, you know, just sitting there, Moogie jumping in on him right into his, you know, into his face, not into his back or anything. Ah, man. That must have been a bit heartbreaking.
No weapon swaps again on NSF. Seems to be working in Moogie's favor as well, though.
Psyche's just going strong. He's almost on the other side already. Let's see how aggressively he picks off somebody here. Just lurking in the train.
Moogie's also lurking in a train.
Just chilling in the thousand train. He doesn't have to worry about the side lane on that side either.
Ooh. Moogie's 48. BK's on 10. RTJ gets the kill on Moogie.
Quick trade from Scriber here. Also taking down BK. Psyche now Psyche doesn't work here. Now if he jumps into Scriber directly, yep, he will win this fight.
Very interesting aggressive plays from Psyche here.
Well, that leaves the question. Is Psyche the more valuable assault asset, or would BK be? I mean, BK now here is doing a pretty okay job. He's, you know, racking up a bunch of points. RTJ has mostly been the support act here, like his class states, usually pushing in with somebody else. Not getting that much points in return.
Moogie with the MX, Tentacle with the ZR.
They're really not hesitant with switching up the weapons on NSF here.
It was working for, you know, a brief period, and...
So all of them seem to be in the south alley here, just relaxing, hanging out, waiting for a moment to strike. None of Worst NT seems to realize this. Psyche just getting picked off as he went out from the backside again. But how aware are they that they're in the south alley? Scriber's just peeking over there a few times, but...
Oh, Moogie's anticipating it if he manages to stay alive.
Moogie is after BK here. They're really just going at it. RTJ just taking out Tentacle here from a flank. Seems like they didn't really expect anyone from there after all. Those recons facing, BK just winning this fight, it's back to 1v1.
And Scriber gets
1v2, oops. Now it's 1v1.
Very interesting to see how the situation plays out.
Well, Scriber has a firepower, he has more health, but he doesn't have the advantage of speed. Transit is pretty good for, you know, jumping sudden corners or similar things like that. Scriber seems to be very focused on the ghost in this case.
Only 15 seconds to go. I think both sides are going to potentially play it safe. Yeah, 2, 1, and timeout.
Maybe good for both sides in this case. I mean, BK had lower health. It works in his favor. They're in the lead. But I'm pretty sure Scriber was also a bit afraid of, you know, losing another round, making the advantage grow even bigger. Now, even point-wise, both teams seem to be fairly equal, both Recons and Assault being on the Sergeant state here. None of them really switching their lineups, and the strats seem to be fairly streamlined on both sides as well. Psyche being the aggressive part of the team most of the time, BK just coming in afterwards, and RTJ being the supportive role to push when engagements happen. Ooh! The dead pack buddy!
...44 HP with the MX himself.
RTJ just softening him up a bit. I'm just really sad that that debt rush didn't work out for BK. He could have potentially got two people here. He was right between them. It was the first debt rush of the game as well. Interesting about Transit as well is that both teams have not been using the Ghost as much as they have been on the other maps. Ooh, Scriber's on him here. Ooh. Very well predicted right here. That leaves out the most aggressive link of the team, him now jumping right into the support. Taking down Woogie on accident! I'm not sure if that kill was intentional, because Tentacle was usually, like, mostly blocking the shots. Or usually he would be the one he would aim for first. But nope. That stray bullet probably ended Moogie right there, just out of nowhere. So the lineups, still very static. Jinrai back in the lead. Now, things are really getting interesting. If NSF is coming back, we might be looking at a really tight match for the start of the tournament. Possibly the tightest match of a start of any tournament in NT. Just the fact that we're going to three maps very early is nice. RTJ is the one that's giving the intel here. I can confirm that his calling will be very lively today, because he has been very hyper earlier today when we played Counter-Strike. BK is starting to make a move. Maybe he's going to be the aggressive link of the team, because Psyche himself, he's just relaxing, he's taking it easy now. He's playing against his standard he has been, you know, just calling for this map. Moogie's the only one that's really moving now. I don't think that they expect BK just lurking on the rails, though. They might just think that everybody's in the Southern Alley again.
Moogie's in a very interesting position. Oh, Moogie gets the frag.
Ooh, a very hard counter against that here. BK being the only one alive was because he wasn't in the Southern Alley. Will he be able to turn this around? Will he be able to turn this around, rather? Moogie has an MX. He's the lowest on HP here. BK only has a set R carbine, so firepower is not in his favor. Now they got the booby bonus. Scriber's just, you know, pushing it up. Not much to do. But it seems like BK nearly got Tentacle by just face-planting through him.
Wasn't expecting just for you to suddenly see the two, the two guys just shooting at each other, standing right inside of each other as well.
And seems like Suna has connection issues. They're now hopping over to the K stream, which cannot hear our moderation. So, or a commentation, rather. I'm not sure if we're back, so. Yeah, I'm not seeing anything happening here. Okay, says we're back. Okay. Sorry for the few connection issues right here. Seems like the stream was having a few things going on. We're back here. Not much has happened. We're still on a 4-3, unless you've been kicked off at the 4-2. NFF is slowly moving up. The lineups haven't changed. The playstyle is back to the aggressive self of Psyche's on Psyche's end. There's a lot of engagements and pre-firing, but none of the shots are actually connecting up until now. Psyche's just taking the initiative to flank while the other people are luring the attention to them. Scriber also trying to flank, or maybe just, you know, get a more fortified position in the south alley. But I keep noticing that both teams just... I'm not sure if much coordination is going on when they're, you know, sweeping the map like this. I mean, now they're back to sticking together. And I know that Psyche has been issued to, you know, do the aggressive part, but... things are that... most of the time, they just seem to, you know, walk very uncontrolled, uncoordinated. At least I personally can't really see much communication besides calling out positions when that happens.
Ruby just gets the lucky kill on RTJ.
VK just daring it, running past. They're on the chase. And he just got away before the timer ran out. Jesus. Well, that was a very close tie, and it was a good tie as well. Well, I will call a tie, because timeouts don't really give anybody points. Because if BK would have, you know, kept facing him just a second longer, he would have been dead. And that would have evened him out. That would have been a 4-4. But, Moogie now coming as a lieutenant. Did he pick a shotgun? He did. Surprisingly, you know, held back and reserved with that shotgun, though. I would have expected him to just jump people. So the first few initiations are going on. People are softening up. Psyche now ending the process by, you know, taking out the support here. If RTJ has smokes left, now is his chance, especially on transit. Smoking up pretty much the center or one of the trains will be vital. Scriber very keen on the trains. He's been sitting in those so much. Seems like the shotgun is paying off after all. We're back at the 2v2 situation, just that RTJ can utilize smokes and Moogie has the shotgun. Now there's the smoke. He's now out of smokes. He's picking off somebody through the smoke though. Not just chilling, but actually abusing the fact that he had line of sight. And then getting Moogie because he saw his little Sue ahead. Push past the smoke.
Very interesting to see if NSF can pull this back. After all, Jinrai only need 2 round wins.
And Jinrai also has their lieutenant now. Will Psyche actually make use of it or not? Psyche sitting on his MX, going the safe route.
There's a weapon swap in NSF. Between Moogie and, Tentacle, yeah. Moogie's got the MX. Tentacle with the ZR.
I'm not really sure why he would give Tentacle a ZR. I mean, this way he could have just given him a shotgun because he's support, lieutenant. I wouldn't hand the ZR carbine to the support as, at this stage.
Maybe shooting a corpse.
Ooh. Peeking that window for just a second too long. Moogie's kind of pinned here, trying to get out of the situation as fast as he can. They know he's back there, though. He knows that he's kind of in a bad situation himself, too.
Can I go with Psyche?
I'm pretty sure Moogie is heavily relying on Tentacle cleaning up a bit more now. RTJ slowly coming close. Ooh. Moogie got out of there by now, but... Oh, he's directly going for the ghost. He's not even holding back. He's straight up just going for it. Good call there. RTJ is in the south alley, not really able to do much. North alley, I think it is.
Moogie gets the cap.
This cap means that they got a second lieutenant on board on NSF. Also means that they're close to balancing it out here. For some reason, I keep saying that the Northern Alley is the Southern Alley. I'm not sure why. So they got the point advantage. They do not have the rounds advantage in this case, but... Does Scriber even utilize anything of it? Nope, he's also going MX. Safe routes for everyone. I can understand. YMX is very versatile. Plus, if you drop it once you die, it's not going to make much of a difference. If you drop the SRS or the AA, that is pretty vital. Now Psyche pushed up all the way in the northern alley, ready to push out. Let's see if he makes use of it. Ooh, Tentacle doesn't even see him. Now everybody's onto him. Psyche doing way more damage than he should have in this situation, given that he even was outnumbered. Things look a bit rough here for Moogie. His only tool is his speed and the MX. Will he make use of it? I mean, BK is in a bad spot himself. Low HP, set are long. I'm not sure why he would pick this here. And then there's RTJ, which, if he ends up by himself, will be dealing with the ghost. Everybody's taking it a bit slow.
Moogie runs away right as one pops up.
It could be that he's trying to play on time here. Or he's just waiting for a good moment to drop. Because if he drops now, he would get RTJ. What is he doing? Oh, he pulls back. Very unfortunate timing. He was right there.
BK going for the cap.
Well, BK's going up. I mean, they pretty much know now that Moogie's just up there. What will BK do, though? Oh, he's sending our... No. I'm not sure what's happening. They don't got much time left. They only got 9 seconds. Moogie is definitely playing time here. Nope, none of them are pushing now. It's too late, I think.
Too late? Yep.
Yep, it definitely is. Just a second too late. And Moogie gets a post-round kill. Not much of a difference, he's been a lieutenant already, but... Three more points for either of the Smelly Skanks members, and we might be looking at another lieutenant. Tentacle needs a few more points to go, but so far none of the people have been actually using the lieutenant weapon, so it doesn't really make a difference. Lineups haven't been changing in the past either. Well, very strange.
Well, he's still trading the ZR.
I personally still think that the shotgun might be a better choice, but each turn it on.
Moogie's just depth hacked the ghost.
BK is back to defending the upper part. I don't even think I've seen any engagements up in the vents before, because NSF usually has been going the lower pass, dealing with Psyche that usually ends up behind them. I'm not sure how they let this happen all the time, but Psyche always pushes past at least one person. This is the first time, I think, that he actually hasn't managed to kill anyone before his aggressive push went down.
He's getting info with a ghost.
Yeah.
Oh, there goes RTJ. BK gets the kill on Scryboat.
This might be the chance that they need. They might be able to even it up now. 5-5, and the morale for both teams should be fairly equal here. Or Jinrai's morale might suffer. We can't forget that those tournament matches are not just something about demonstrating skill and tactics. It's also about, like, you know, keeping your mentality. You got to remain focused. You got to remain calm. Especially with people like RTJ, this might be something that could get down to their bones.
BK is just gently playing it safe.
Tentacles going up. BK is just ready to pick him off here. Ooh.
He hesitates, but that allows Moogie to get the kill.
It looks like he got stuck there. I don't think he was intending to stand still afterwards. Because there is that little corner that stops him from moving, and that's exactly what he stopped on, so... If that wouldn't have happened, he could have gotten away. Maybe. Big maybe, because Moogie was right on there as well.
Yeah, it was very close between the two.
BK is now using the carabine. I'm not sure about that choice.
Moogie's dropping... Yep, weapon trade as usual. It seems to be working for them, so... It's a decent trade-off.
Well, I would say so-and-so, given that it's even points. It's definitely worth doing for a recon with an MX.
It'd be very interesting to see some shotgun players from Moogie again.
Right now, a heavy lockdown is happening. Smelly Skanks is not able to push up, and two of them are really softened up here.
Yeah, we have RTJ on 70, and Psyche on 19.
It could be that Psyche now finally has been locked down efficiently, and that, you know, they're actively preventing any pushes in that regard. The smoke now close to Psyche also makes it hard for him to predict where he's coming from.
Psyche gets the kill on Moogie, but Tentacle manages to get Psyche. Leaves.
Very efficient grenade.
2v1 and RTJ is eliminated. Meaning that it is 6 to NSF, 5 to Jinrai, very close.
BK is moving into the Lieutenant Leagues. I'm very curious on if he's using the shotgun and if he will be aggressive with it. Because if BK starts to pick up the pace together with Psyche, because Psyche already has been very destructive by himself, this might be... Nope, okay, never mind. BK is using the Sadar Carbine. I'm not sure about why.
Moogie's got the MX again. Nothing seems to be really changing on NSF.
Well, Jinrai doesn't seem to be changing either. None of them pick lieutenant weapons. None of them actually, you know, change the classes. It's a very static match so far, besides a few changes in the lineup of, like, Smelly Skanks when shit hit the fan.
Generally, tactics seem to be the same as well. It's always a mixture between playing aggressively and then just hanging back.
Or, as Smelly Skanks did a few times, chilling out in the northern alley to fortify. I think that also was ghost dependent, because usually they had control of the ghost doing so. Now all of, like, both teams are fairly scrambled. RTJ is just holding the top part. I don't think anything's gonna happen there soon, unless Moogie now ends up jumping in. Ooh. He's actually taking the vents. He might be attacked sometime soon here. Psyche's taken down. This takes out the most aggressive link of their team. RTJ is starting to get pinned. He shouldn't be scared of initiating a fight here. He has more health. He shouldn't have backed off here, I think. Okay, BK is down. Quick trade happening here. It's down to RTJ. In a massive firefight, 1v1, 15 to 100 HP. This is the last round if Worst NT is now winning this. Tentacle has a lot of responsibility on his hands to turn this into their favor and winning this match. But RTJ has an even bigger burden going on because he's the one that softened up. He's the one that doesn't have control of the ghost. He's relying on the timeout, which is happening, but man.
Yep.
15 HP from the loss here. I'm pretty sure his nerves must be racing.
You can definitely feel the tension between both teams here.
Round 16.
Will this be the final round?
Two lieutenants, one sergeant, both supports being the sergeant, the other ones being the lieutenants. BK not utilizing this, nearly daring a push that could have cost him his life, I can safely say this, because he straight up went through the vents at the top, not checking the surroundings. RTJ gets softened up, they now know his position. Psyche pushed in harshly, he's on the other side, maybe spotted already. Nope, Scriber just goes down. If Psyche keeps this up, he might be getting another drop here. He just has to make sure that Tentacle is outside of the smoke. RTJ didn't utilize his own smokes yet, I'm pretty sure. He might be able to turn this around for him as soon as Tentacle is out. Moogie, though, back at the top, just checking things out. BK now also at the top, almost running into him. Psyche gets another one. It's now a 1v3 situation.
Ooh.
Moogie finally ended Psyche at a big cost. And BK is swarming around so close. Also going down. Not a single point of damage towards Moogie. It's 1v1. Getting really close again. They got a lot of speed versus a lot of health. I can say this safely because support 66 is a big difference here. Though Moogie has an MX, so it shouldn't be as big of a problem. RTJ has a ghost in a fairly reachable position as well. So... yeah, he's doing the right thing. He's falling back to it. He's playing it safe. Moogie has to get there or has to time it out. Timing out works in the favor of NSF. But...
looks like it's going to be another timeout.
I can understand that. There's a lot on the line for both of them. If RTJ would have won this, they would have evened it out, and then it would come down to this typical sudden death situation. And there's a tie. But Psyche was so destructive. It was so close there. They could have had it. Not sure what happened with BK there. I'm really not sure. Because he had the drop, he would have had the chance. He was the one on full HP. Maybe at that point, if he had the shotgun, he could have ended it. Just maybe. But BK is not utilizing it. He's not touching the shotgun. He's sticking with a carabine. Scriber's also just sticking to the MX, and so is Psyche. Quick drop in the elevator.
Oh.
Psyche's push has been shot down. He's not able to really advance now. Now it's in BK's hands to do something. I don't think it's a good idea, though, that RTJ is pushing the top. That is really tense. I'm surprised nobody shot at him. Both teams are in positions that aren't really push-friendly right now.
Scriber playing it awfully slow and safe.
Understandably so. I mean, they have the advantage. They don't have anything to push for.
Moogie's pushing, however.
Moogie is getting in here. He might be getting the drop on Psyche. Psyche doesn't turn around. Psyche
gets taken out by
Moogie. Not turning around. Moogie was not messing around there. He was doing it, give or take. Now, RTJ and BK have to move from the position. This is where I say the top part wasn't a good idea, because he doesn't have many choices. People will aim for the top or the bottom. What was that?
What?
Okay.
What?
It seems like that was a very uncoordinated fading through each other to the point where Tentacle didn't even realize. Did he not understand?
Scriber and Moogie versus BK now.
BK has to play at either time or manage to take out both. If he plays a time, we might be looking at something that stretches itself like a gum.
Oh, Scribe's getting the info. Not even going back to pick up his gun.
And we're having another extension here. Man, I'm starting to get really tense myself because it's always so close for one side, and then they break it down into this, waiting game. Now the 18th round.
Round 18, longest NT match I've seen.
I mean, we're getting close to the CCC versus Yuredan we had last year, where we had 6 rounds of overtime on Dawn.
Oh God, yeah.
But we're getting there. We're slowly getting there. Oh, somebody in the chat also mentioned that. That's funny.
It's
So,
just one of those moments.
as we see here, Ghost is in North Shinelli, so we got somebody positioned there from Smelly Skanks. Psychic attempting his very daring push. He has been spotted though. Now he has to do something. He's in this cheeky spot between both smokes. Now falling back through one, taking a lot of damage in the process. The support making use of what he does best. He takes the chance to take down Psyche.
Evened out now.
Hold on, an MXS. That's interesting. BK's using the silence variant of the MX.
Movies.
Oh, this is so
Oh, so.
tense. Tentacle is coming right up behind BK. He's missing him by just a second. Now he's the one that's on the ghost. Both of them are fairly low, and both of them are just, scrambling up again. Tentacle's just staring at the ghost, and BK's just, swarming around it. Will they actually finally initiate combat, or will they just relax? Nope, BK's just sitting in a corner.
Camp
Come
Tokyo.
on. Come on,
Coward.
guys.
Someone's gonna have to bite the bullet. Might be BK.
BK is coming in. He's slowly nearing the ghost. He has another 11 seconds to do something. Come on. You have the health
Move.
points. Just jump him.
Move.
4, 3, 2,
Yeah, timeout.
1.
Timeout.
Nope. We are looking at a
Timeout, Tokyo.
19th round.
Gets the exit frag. Just don't understand. Everyone's playing it so slowly.
Well, they even have a full lieutenant stack on both teams now. Is there at least
Movement.
one utilization of recons? Yeah, okay, cool. So Moogie is switching up his shotgun for YMX, as I was expecting the other team to do. Instead, VK is sticking to the carabine. I don't know. Very aggressive push through the Norse and Ellie from Scriber. He's the one being the aggressive flank for once. Or, well, yeah, Psyche also did the same. So they got both assaults being very aggressive on the other side already. First exchanges of bullets, none of the shots connecting. Both supports just playing it out here. Moogie's getting the first vital hits.
RTJ is soften up, 61 HP.
So, Scriber, even though he pushed up very far, oh,
Ooh.
pushes at the wrong time. RTJ woos the softened up part, just takes out Scriber. People from, like Smoogie, now taking the initiative to go through the Norse alley, not able to take on RTJ by himself. Tentacle, 100 health against 3 people. He is being chased. People now know where he's at. He's now just relaxing. That's his only choice, even though I cannot call that a relaxing anymore, just chilling in a corner, because he's sweating bullets. And they're just, pushing in on him. They're checking the situation. Tentacle has to do something. He has to.
Has to move, otherwise he's screwed.
And they get onto him, taking him
Time.
down. Not a
Six
single
six.
member on Jinrai lost here.
Round 20 here.
Now we're in the situation where it gets even more tense. Both teams only are 1 point away from taking this match as theirs. Round 20.
Mugi swapping, Xiaolong for the MX. Very static still on Jinrai, no weapon swaps. Psyche with the beginning hops.
That's not the Sidar Long, by the way, that's just a Carabine.
Did I say long? Like half awake right now.
Tentacle smoking himself out, just holding down the corner.
Yeah, everyone's playing with carbines.
Very peculiar. So there's first exchange of bullets again. There's also some dead play going on. Let's see how well that fares for them. The ghost seems like it's in the northern part of the map once more, I think. Yep. Just surprising that nobody's actually going for the northern alley in this case besides BK.
Psyche taking some hits, he's on 46 HP.
Mugi also a bit softened up in that engagement up top.
Oh,
he's running
into
Scriber. Scriber taking no hits. Everybody's getting into heated engagements.
RTJ kills Scriber.
Even though they have the advantage of numbers in terms of people, the health is pretty equal here. Many heated engagements still going on, mostly in the center. Tentacle got shot up from behind. Engagements going on up north, close to the ghost. BK just, you know, hidden running it. Now sticking with Psyche here, you know, making use of their numbers. Down to a 1v3 once more. Tentacle spotted by the ghost. Pushed upon. Jinrai just finishing it off. That means Smelly Skanks is actually taking transit. Also taking up the first match, eliminating them from the game.
Very tight on both ends.
What a close match. Now Psyche is standing there with the SRS, not taking it before that. How ironic.
Would have been very interesting to see how it would be used in a match like this.
I mean, transit would have been a nice pick, you know. You go down the stairs, you pick down the long lanes, or the long lane, rather. It could have proven itself useful. Nobody was really, you know, willing to take it, though. Nobody was willing to go for it. I would have loved to see it. I would have loved to see more AA plays as well, but I don't think any of the two teams actually went from the MX pass or for any other support weapons besides the shotgun on Mugi's side to give it to the support. All in all, quite heavy pushes, quite aggressive gameplay as well, but I feel like, you know, the whole fact of being able to switch up lineups was not used a lot. It was not utilized. BK didn't go for it. I'm actually very surprised that they ended up, you know, deciding to match for themselves. Because Oilstain made it seem like BK's, you know, insistence on playing recon could have bitten their ass. Oh man, quite a match. That's for sure. Now, as the closing here, Leapfrog, bring us more numbers. Just bring them.
Well, Psyche was probably the MVP of the map with 20 kills.
Jesus.
He's followed by Mugi, who got around 18 kills. And Scriber got a little more quiet on this map. He had some trouble to get the kills, I guess.
Could be very dependent for the map for him then.
Yeah, probably.
I mean, now we had our first look into transit and competitive play in a 3v3 format as well. I personally can safely say it's good. It didn't turn stale, besides the fact that they started hiding, but they could have done that on any map, to be honest.
Osaka's popping up in the Discord saying, interview!
Yeah.
Well, I mean, we can do an interview here. We can just hop in and talk with them. Seems like they all left, though, besides Psyche and BK. Let's drag them in.
Psyche moved in from CSGO Lounge by
so
producer Seth.
Let's lift the mute
BK
here.
201 moved in from CSGO Lounge by producer Seth.
Yeah,
oh,
ties,
okay, BK deafened himself. I guess he does not want to talk
with
us.
Oh, we're in Discord, producer. We're in Discord.
Ah.
That's why it sounds like I'm talking to no one.
Well, people want an interview. Nobody else is here. Well, Hosomi is still here, but they're not on the... well, yeah, okay, you're the only two players that, you know, have an interview choice here, so if you want... Okay, never mind, they definitely
deafen themselves.
Oh, okay. Let me, you know, ask up the others to see if they're interested.
I haven't played NT for a long time, you know. Like, I don't play that much, so
I personally.
You're BK, right? I haven't seen you play in like 6 months or something.
Like, shouldn't we go to the mumble? Like, here, look at the chat here, and Zip is telling us just go to the mumble for the post discussion.
Okay.
Yeah, like we could go there. So they get the post match stuff on the.
Seems like we
AMP.
Have the people so on stream. The teams taken away.
Yeah, let's go mumble and see you there. I'm safe to talk to there.
So people just joined them instead?
Is it on Caster?
Apparently we are doing it on Mumble. I didn't realize. I was told to join Discord.
Yeah, right,
I'm here.
We technically, we should be doing it here because more people are watching the hitbox.
Yeah, I didn't realize. Someone said to join Discord, so I did, but... We're getting people in here now, so...
Okay.
Yeah, I prefer Mumble all the time.
Muji moved in from Agile's Mumble server by producer Sen. RTJ moved in from Agile's Mumble server by producer Sen.
Scribe now we're getting everyone
from
in
Mumble
here.
Server by producer Sen.
Perfect.
Mugi moved to Neotokyo.
Why is Mugi changing?
I don't know. Did you track him?
In from Neotokyo by producer Sen.
Everybody here, yeah?
Okay, don't leave us. Now, before this gets a bit too uncoordinated, let's just start off with the winners here. So, congratulations to the Smelly Skanks, first of all.
Thank you.
It was a very tense game for the first, you know, match on the whole tournament. How do you feel?
Go ahead, Saki.
I thought it was a very enjoyable game to play. Like, there was lots of close rounds and a lot of, like, interesting stuff that people do, but like I definitely feel like there's a lot we can improve on, and there was a lot of rounds we made loads of mistakes on.
Improve as in the format or your composition?
Our gameplay.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, well, pretty much the same with me. I haven't played NT in a long time, and coming back to competitive NT, it's really nice. And obviously, I know Psyche and RTJ pretty long back, like 2-3 years maybe, I don't know, even more.
3 years, I'm pretty sure.
Yeah, and we know each other pretty well, and it's nice to play with them, and I don't know, it's kind of relaxed NT, not too, like, sweaty, but it's still, like, it got really intense while we played, and I don't know, I got fired up, and every time Psyche or RDJ gets around, I'm like, fuck yes. I'm really excited about it. So it was really fun. It was really fun.
That's when you realize that a team is made for each other. When they're actually, you know, when they're around, that they get more hyped up and fired up and they work together. The synergy is there. Chemistry is what makes a team or breaks it most of the time. Would you say that you got nervous?
Yeah.
At all?
Fuck yes.
RTJ, I think RTJ was about to collapse.
I'm always about to collapse. I mean, I pointed out earlier that we were playing Counter-Strike, and RTJ has been very on edge for some reason today.
my mental sanity, I believe.
Well, did it get worse?
No, fortunately.
There was a fair amount of in unintelligible squealing, but apart from that, he was okay. He pulled off some nice clutches and stuff, so that's good.
You moved on, regardless of it being tense for RTJ earlier, being very on edge and just, you know, flimsy. You managed to pull through, and I will say this much, you will be facing my team, which has been handicapped to be in the second round early. I will tell you this much.
Aren't you playing a preliminary first, or is it like a bye or something?
Huh?
Aren't you supposed to be playing a
preliminary
first? Or
I, I'm not exactly sure how it works. I only just know that we've been in the second round early on. I'm not sure if there has been tweaks to this or not.
If not,
you will be facing my team, or rather Tenshi's team, because Tenshi is the team leader in this case. And seems like I have to drag in somebody. I forgot. Before I move on to the other team a bit, BK, a question to you. Why recon, not assault?
Psyche gonna suggest that one before, like, this is a long time ago, but I don't know, maybe two months ago or something, when we discussed about this tournament. So it was like kind of that I could play recon, so I'm playing it. And that's just how we go.
I'm just an AIDS recon, so we needed someone who was, like, at least competent at it.
Yeah, but for me, to be honest, I could have get shit done, like, fucking that Austin match. I was so fucking AIDS.
Yeah, we all hoped for you to pick Assault. Everybody in the chat was like, come on, this is bad. Pick Assault. Come on, switch it up.
Yeah, I have a fucking...
I mean, he did pick Assault, like...
Yeah, it was very late.
We all just got dicked, like, every single time.
It ended up to be very late for you to switch around. I would have done it earlier if I was, you know, in charge of that team. Yeah. But each to their own. You managed to pull through, so
Nothing was working for us on Oilstain at all, for anyone, really.
I mean, other than that, I predicted, you know, RTJ being support, because I can safely say he's doing a very solid job on that part.
For real?
You have been...
I'm not believing it. Seriously. You may believe in it, but I don't.
From an observer's perspective, even though you weren't the one that has been racking up the most points, you usually came in to, you know, play your role, adding into the firepower, softening them up. Because especially in competitive play, you cannot say that kills are everything. If you're doing the part of softening it up, you know, making it easier for the rest of your team to take them down, you're already doing a good job, and that's what you've been doing.
Yeah, and also so... RTJ, like, provided cover sometimes, like going in front, because he's got more help. So, he did a really good job with that.
That's, like, at least, I guess, the basic, like... seriously, it's not about the frags, but more like being in the correct positioning. Like, I've been struggling with taking proper map control. Maybe because I haven't played as much as BK. No, well, I haven't played much NT in the late.
I already called out that you are the returning team that hasn't played in a while. That you are like longer in the game, but. More rusty, I would say. And then I also added that, you know, worst NT are people that have been playing more recently, that have been going on more actively, and it's very close to that. It was one little round that was decisive in that case. So, yeah.
Yeah, I wanted to go with the recon once, like, some more into that, like that. Well, everybody knows that I've been playing quite a lot CSGO and other games, and coming back to NT, facing Mookie on here transit, and that fucking recon running and jumping thing, I couldn't hit shit. And I was like, what the hell is this? And it was really hard for me to fucking... I was super rusty. Like,
yeah, one of the times it really stood out was when Moogie was by himself, 44 HP, on the stairs.
You jumped him, and you didn't
get in a single hit. I personally just said, if you would have picked the shotgun there, you might have been a bit more lucky, but...
Oh, that round was so frustrating. I, like, got two kills and hit another for 60, and then fuck it.
But these kind of situations, you can see that we haven't really played that much. Yeah. And it's so...
The communication was quite off that round as well. Like, my call, like, I tried to call out where he was, but he was just, like, moving around so much.
Yeah.
So, I mean,
lacking of game awareness, basically.
Yeah, it pretty much went the way I predicted it, in the way of it being very tight. I didn't expect it to be that tight, but... You pretty much made everybody in the chat go nuts. So
I'm sure it was intense game to watch.
It doesn't matter if you won or lost. You definitely provided a very fair demonstration of skill that both teams are capable of. And on that note, I would like to jump over to Worst NT here for a bit. So how are you guys?
Hey, what's up? Not great.
Relatively okay.
I mean, there's nothing to be that sad over. It's all in good fun. That's what you have to consider.
Yeah. I went to enter this as a friendly match.
Can safely say that we won't have an incident like we had last year with a person that I will not say the name of that kind of took things to a new level of...
Got a little aggro about Neo
Tokyo. A new level of taking things a bit too serious. But
yeah,
all in all, you did a very good job. You demonstrated that you're definitely not something to underestimate as a unit. And on that note, I would like to, first of all, address you, Mugi.
Yeah.
Would have worked better.
I'm not really sure.
You're not sure? I personally really like the fact that once you were lieutenant, you switched up the shotgun, because that's a pretty safe pick to make on small maps like this.
Yeah.
What were the key strats that seemed to work best for you? What do you think is something that, you know, was a heavy hitter?
On oil stain, giving me the shotgun in the very beginning seemed to work. I'm not a very strong player with like the SRM. Like, I don't know. It's so hard to explain.
Strong player or not, you seem to throw them off once you started to jump around, you know, getting all flimsy. So I would also like to say you haven't been the most aggressive kind of recon, especially BK either.
Yeah.
Like, both of the recons have been very reserved. What goes?
Well, I'm not really a recon player. Like, when I play normally, I'm an assault player, and so, like, I don't really have that much practice as a recon. And I was just sort of, I didn't really trust my abilities to, like, make a push or to, like, just be more aggressive.
Oh, seems like the stream is having a few issues here. Suna has been having a hard time to keep it up. We kind of had a loss of info for a few moments there on transit.
Oh, that's unfortunate.
Yeah, I'm not sure if we're back up yet or not. Let me just check on a few people here.
Supposed to be... didn't want to play anymore, so we picked up Kate pretty much last minute as our support player. So
okay,
I think...
stream is back. Cool. Well, I was thinking that Alice is going to be on a team, but then I was informed that Alice is not part of the team anymore and just a merc.
Yeah.
So I think part of the issue that we had going in is we had so many roster changes.
I see. Well, would you say, even though it was a right-off-the-bat kind of decision, that the chemistry worked out?
Oh, no. Technical play. Great.
Everything
just,
worked fine.
That's good to hear.
Alice is a stronger recon player than Mugi, and I think that our initial lineup was going to be Mugi.
Because I haven't been playing that much myself, I can't give that much input about Mugi being a support and how well he would handle that, but would you say that if he would be shoved into the fat suit, would you be able to pull it?
I think it would have gone better, just because support play is much more similar to assault than recon.
Well, you were pretty much a recon most of the time when I expected to. I don't even think you changed up the lineup team. Yeah, the whole team didn't change once from what I saw.
We thought about it on oil stain,
either.
Yeah,
like,
and we,
both
we
of
just,
the recons have been very
recon.
Reserved. Yeah, there was no reason to change after all. You kept winning. It was very solid.
Yeah, we might have wanted to switch it up on transit, though, especially when we started getting into those constant tie rounds.
Yeah, we were wondering about when it will finally come to a close here.
If that's, like, the one complaint that I have is the way that the point scoring system is set up, but I really don't have any sort of suggestions on how to improve that.
That's been a long-running discussion for a
Yeah, and it wasn't an issue until we got to transit.
Yeah. You had no fear taking any sort of engagements there.
Yeah.
How does that feel? Like, how does it feel being in charge of, like, the situation as a newcomer team, sort of?
Well, I mean, that's just how I play assault, is I just try to take aim battles with people and try to kind of out-game sense them, get in better positioning, that kind of stuff. And it'll bite me in the ass sometimes. Like, I'll jump into RTJ and it'll just absolutely destroy me because he's a support.
Don't you think you might be getting a bit full of yourself when you start dominating like that, or did you keep
it
calm?
No, 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 no. Because I've had that happen to me in pugs before, and they can always blow up in your face.
Yeah, that's what we've been seeing in past games as well. I'm definitely not pointing at, you know, Yurei Dan's match on Oilstain taking PZ Train. No, no. Yeah.
The PZ Train.
Yes. Everybody remembers that. But I think that's one of the biggest scandals that happened in the history of those freaking tournament matches. And that's why I'm asking. People do get full of themselves and they get ahead of themselves thinking, oh man, I'm dominating. Might as well, you know, shove in a bit more.
Yeah, I'll say that on transit when we were like 5-2, 5-3, something like that, we were feeling really good about it. And then it just got to back-to-back-to-back ties, and I think it really ground us down in terms of just mental capacity.
Oh yeah, I can't imagine. If it starts coming down to ties, once again, first that experience from last year, we faced CCC. Agile was not there, because Agile used to be our main link of, you know, keeping the cool, calling the strats, calling up variations of what we should do. Instead, we were Lage, Taza, me, Mega, and Marumo.
Oh,
and we
God.
Drugged out into 6 rounds of overtime. 6 whole rounds of overtime were so down that everybody just wanted the game to end. So I can relate to, you know, the whole thing of the longer it goes, the more it wears you down. And maybe that was the whole reason you lost in the end. There were several occasions where you had the chance to take down BK, for example, very low on health, and you could have just ended it early.
And I think part of that is also, and is my mic kind of quiet?
No, it's fine.
Okay. And I think that's another part of the issue that we had is the ping. I mean, you can't ignore the ping when it comes to this game. It makes a huge difference.
Oh, yeah.
So, and I think that's part of the reason we did so well in Oilstain is we're all at 50-60 ping versus the Europeans at 120, 130. And then we'd switch back to transit and it's, you know, I'm back up to 160 again and I lose fights that I just, you know,
yeah.
It's definitely a, that's what
it's very
to
fair
do.
To assume, yeah.
Yeah, but that's why, you know, it comes down to a coin flip to determine which servers we get on and you switch off back and forth between us, so I can't, you know.
I can agree that, like, the ping situation was a very big problem on Oilstain. There was, like, that one round where Mugi had the AA-13 in the kiosk, like West Alleyway, and he was like jumping up and down with the AA-13, and I had the shotgun and I shot him three rounds into the
And I had the exact same thing happen to me on transit where Psyche comes out bouncing up and down and I just can't hit a shot on him.
Yeah, the one in the North Alleyway, yeah. That was
because you did that to me a couple of times with the dragon hitbox, and it's so hard to deal with.
That's the only problem with
small games
like this.
But it's a fundamental flaw in the game. There's really not much you can do about it.
Yeah, we don't have the resources to hold a land, so.
But I guess, like, maybe my suggestion would be if it gets down to a 6-6, where it's just tied up match point, maybe just disable the round timer or something like that and just have them play it out as an overtime or something. I don't
know. An overtime would, like a CS-style overtime, would be the same sort of deal, though. Like, it could go infinitely.
Yeah.
I would say that we should find a workaround for something like this. I'm not sure how it would look like in terms of workaround.
I wouldn't be as frustrated with the scoring issue if it wasn't single elimination. But I understand that, you know, people are busy. It's hard to get a double elimination tournament round robin, anything like that going.
Not only double elimination, but the fact that, you know, the best way it would have worked out with 15 teams was group stages, but that would drag out the whole tournament again. We had bad experiences with that in the past.
I understand why they went single elimination.
Yeah,
I would prefer a different system, but, you know, people have real lives to take care of. They have better things to do than play in Neo Tokyo tournament.
First pro Neo Tokyo team scribe and make it happen.
That's the only reason the other games seem to work out, because, you know, there's dedicated teams that, you know, make room for just that. People cannot do that for Neo Tokyo. I'm pretty sure that doesn't work.
Yeah, but the Mugi Cake, they played really well, and I think we just got ground down by those tie rounds. You know, it's like we were stuck at 5-6 for 3-4 rounds in a row where we'd be up. You know, it's 2v1, and then a BK just avoids us, and no one gets any points for it.
That's the unfortunate part about the tiring.
It happens over and over again, it starts to get very frustrating.
That's
the unfortunate
part,
yeah. But I think that's just the game, not just the tournament.
Do what you've got to do to win.
Yeah.
And sometimes that just means wearing out the enemy.
Guys, you played perfectly. I mean, you're down a couple of points, you don't want to give us any more than that. It's match point, you got to play for the win. We were doing the same thing as well. And I kind of knew going into the tournament that it would definitely be a legitimate tactic that teams would be using.
Otherwise, it wouldn't be competitive if people aren't.
Like the time rounds mean that, like,
I just think the timer
or something, you just have to be aggressive, like, and push with the ghosts and stuff.
With transit, the way that the map is set up, I think it's a little bit too big, a little bit too complicated compared to Oilstain or Tarmac.
there are a lot of angles to cover and lots of like open flanks, especially.
Yeah, and a lot of ways for you to just get out of the way and not get found.
So now that we had pretty much everybody's input, let's move on to Tentacle, or well, Cake in this case. He's been the only one that has not been giving any insight from his own end here. So, how was it for you?
I guess it was fun. I'm a relatively new player to all these pug matches and this annual tournament. I was called in last minute again, and all the practice we ever had as a team was just me and Moogie yesterday playing around in pubs.
Mm-hmm. So, well, did it grind down to your bones? Did you get nervous?
Well, of course I got nervous, especially with the ping on Tarnmac and Transit. I'm the one who lives the furthest away from Moogie and Scryber and all the Europeans. I'm on the west coast of America. Somehow Scryber had higher ping than me, but a lot of the times when I was aiming at a person, right, the ping difference was determinant on whether or not I'd get shots in. I remember an instance over at Transit where I was facing someone head-on with a ZR long, and I shot first, and I got all my rounds in, but I was killed somehow.
I'm still thinking about the whole ping and server thing. I'm pretty sure there's an entity to work that out. For example, a knife route that determines which server gets picked.
Yeah. But for that, we did a coin flip, right?
Yeah, we did a coin flip.
I didn't notice that. I didn't know that. Okay, that works.
Yeah, we flipped
coin flip is also just as fair.
I flipped a coin.
Because and they gave us the option to just decide which server we're going to play on first, and that didn't seem fair to me, because if I said NA, we probably would have won out because of that.
I mean, we can only speculate now because it has been done. The deed has been done, as people like to say. Once again,
the match was fairly close, and I think that having that lower ping might have made a difference.
Every
for us.
Match has been close. Even the Olsen one was very close at the start before it started, you know, getting more decisive for you guys. And that's, I don't know, I'm just really blown away because from the first match in the tournament, usually you don't expect as much. But people just going in full force and dragging it to the point, last map, 1 point being the difference.
Feels bad, man.
I wouldn't feel bad about it. I would feel really proud. I would just say that you can safely feel proud. You demonstrated your skill. You were really strong there.
We're in a really brutal bracket as well, because even if we beat Smelly Skinks, we go up against Tanga next.
Oh, God.
Fuck everything about that. So good luck with Tanga.
Are you sure it's Tanga? Let me look at the brackets.
Yeah.
Again. Oh, whoops. Yeah, I. Okay.
Yeah, it's totally Tanga.
Yeah, whoops. My bad. I have been looking at the brackets before. I thought for some reason.
Come on,
you're
producer
the ones...
Senpai, get it together.
Yeah. I've been having a hard time today. I didn't think
that
commentating.
Osaka did the same shit.
I wasn't thinking that, like, commentating is going to be, you know, that rough, but we've been at this, like, the stream has been going for 2.5 hours or so.
Oh, yeah, God.
No, 3 hours by now. So yeah, the stream has been on for 3 hours by now.
It took us, what, two hours to finish up that match.
I guess I can deduct, like, 40 minutes of, you know, prep time, so 2.5 hours are a safe bet for how long this has been taking. I'm quite exhausted because it has been also grinding up my nerves just watching, you know.
Yeah.
As a commentator, you cannot be biased, and I wanted both teams to win because I have a high sympathy for both, just because I know I faced BK in the past, I've faced, you know, everybody on BK's team in RDJ, I also faced I also faced Psyche in the past, and then there's, you know, Moogie, and I mean, I don't have much interaction with Cake / Tentacle or you, Scriber, but I have high sympathy with Moogie as well because I know he's a great guy, so.
Yeah, by the time I started playing the game fairly heavily, you're basically done.
Oh, man. I don't know. I just wanted both teams to advance or win personally because both deserve it, and they've proven that they deserve it.
God, why can't I just move to loser's bracket?
Are we not?
Yeah, no, it's single elimination. We're done.
Oh.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Oh. Jake, so that was close. Jake, god damn it, Dan.
Sorry.
I did it I didn't know, to be honest.
No.
That, well, if we lose, that's it. I didn't know about it.
Yeah, no, you're okay. Done if you lose.
Like, oh, I thought, like, if I would have known that, probably I would have played worse or something, you know?
Yeah.
Just completely fucking threw me off and played bad.
Really? I wasn't that nervous going into the matches.
Neither was I. But this transit was really close.
Yeah, transit started to get to me a little bit, honestly. Because we started off really strong. I think we went like 3-0 against you, and you started just clawing back rounds for us.
Like 5 ties drained us.
Man, we have what, 10k viewers?
Kudos to you, though. It was a really good game, and thank you for it.
By the way, BK, I hate you so much. Like, recons, man.
Well, I don't
can't
know.
Stand them. There's one or two rounds on transit where he just started, you know, bunny hopping towards me, and I whiffed every single bullet. And he just murdered me, and you had full 100 health afterwards.
Mm.
There were some rounds that we lost because, you know, you just played well. You played super aggressive and got the advantage and fucking speed us up.
Yeah, but I still feel I held back a lot. Like, I wasn't fully myself.
This isn't even
your comes
form.
To recon, so.
Yeah,
you
only
just reinstalled this morning, BK. So.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, here I can finally confirm my statement. People will just reinstall this game for the tournament. Thank you for confirming.
Oh, that's not too much of a surprise. I mean, producer, you reinstalled for the tournament, right?
No.
You never uninstalled Neo Tokyo.
No. Why would I do that? How dare you assume that? What the hell?
It's a bad game.
I'm like on the next level, to be honest. I always uninstall Neo Tokyo and then I remove the free license from my Steam library. And then I always add it again.
I'll say that going into this match against you guys, we were kind of feeling like you guys might be pretty bad because none of you played in such a long time, but you really got on top of it fast. There wasn't too much of a break-in period.
Oh, well, at least I will speak for myself, but my game awareness was trash. Like, I gave you a fair amount of free kills, but I gave your back, even if I had the info, even if I know where did you kill just a teammate and stuff like that, I just gave my back to you.
Yeah, you definitely, I noticed you do that quite a few times.
Like, because it was just panicking.
I think I killed, like, Psyche and Nortrain on transit, and then you just walked into Alley and gave me your side, and I got a free kill off of you. And you did that a few times.
Yeah, I just gave my back to you people a good bunch of times, so I guess I'm still not in the, like, correct mindset to play this. Maybe because I'm way too used to 5v5 pugs, where people have a load of, a good bunch of corners covered, so you're, like, you don't have to focus about your position way too much.
Yeah, the 3v3 format's really weird. And I guess another...
Still struggling to get used to it.
Yeah, and that's one of the issues that we had coming into this match, is it was hard to find a good team to just pug against, to get some practice in. Because it was always just like a one-sided stomp, and it was hard to get a feel for, you know, what's going to work.
The last 3v3 we did, I believe there was Psyche, there was Snyla. Snyla was still... So it was like 1.5 years ago,
we got
I believe. There was Tsunebosu, maybe. I don't know, this
we lost
was like
7-0 or something.
No, it was a kind of close one. At least it's the only one I did. Maybe you did more than one.
I'm talking about the scrim we played. It was me, Snyder, and Lady versus your team, Scrubber, without you, I think.
It wasn't that one.
Your team was just banging us out every single round.
Yeah.
So, I had a question.
Oh, something.
A lot of you guys reached the Lieutenant rank, but no one really picked any weapons. Is there any reason for that?
I was so tempted to pick up the SRS, but the map where I felt like I could make the biggest difference with the transit.
Yeah.
It's because Lieutenant weapons have some really bad downsides most of the times.
So,
like NMX.
Especially SRS and AA, both really inconsistent with, like, shooting. Like, I picked the AA once on
Tarmac.
On the first, on Tarmac, where we were basically having a nice hedge for...
It was the last round anyway.
Of course, there are the pings as well. Somebody's like 150, you're like 50, 70, and people lag a bit, and the hitboxes might lag, and, you know, it's just a bit sketchy.
And it's kind of walks shit
I'll
like
say, if we were North American server for Transit, I would have picked an SRS at least one round.
Yeah, I was always
because,
thinking you'd probably go onto it,
because
you Because
I'm very comfortable with the SRS on Transit, but, like I was saying...
That's really bad downsides.
Yeah.
Like, that's the problem when you're Tokyo, like the AMAX is basically an all-purpose fucking gun.
There's almost no reason not to take it.
Yeah.
Yeah, and about the LT weapons, the shotguns on this Transit, they're fucking shit. Everybody who's played PUC games, they know if you go that, like, that corridor, that alleyway, was that small office, there's, like, a lot of that class, so you cannot penetrate that class with the shotguns.
Exactly.
Right?
That's why.
So it's really stupid to pick one.
And also in the trains, there's loads and loads of glass as well, so...
Yeah, and if there's a player who knows this, that you've got a shotgun, he can just camp inside the office and toy with you while you have the shotgun, so...
Talking of glass, that round when we were all in the... Our team was all in the north alleyway, and we had the...
Yeah.
You in the fucking window, that was next level as fuck. I was in front of the ghost, and RTJ died to Mugi from behind. And then I peeked to refrag him, and like I just instantly died from the through the window, and because I just completely fucking forgot it was there.
Yeah, Sakana uses this spot
like,
a lot.
Like, where the fuck is he?
Just on the side, is any of you actively in touch with Beans?
Yes.
Can you tell him to when he streams on Twitch next time, not to use /ActiveNewTokyo, but the actual, you know, ActiveNewTokyo player stream. That way, it's easier to find because people follow that actively.
Oh, yeah, sure.
And Rain should have the stream key for that. That way, people, you know, that might have not watched today or something, if you end up streaming on that again sometime, you know, they know their stuff and they hop on there.
I still have the stream open, I believe, so. Like,
The hitbox one is Active New Tokyo, but the Twitch one is Active New Tokyo players.
Yeah.
BK was also streaming.
Yeah, it's just my fault. Like, the most horrible NT for a while.
Okay. I just wish we could have gotten, like, the bracket against YouTube shit or something like that. Like,
oh, yeah.
Yeah, if you like, I can link the... Like, there's gonna be that bot from the stream, so I can link it to your Discord, whatever. Like later on, and you can watch the game from our view if you want. Like you can hear all the stuff and
yeah,
cheering,
I should
do that. It's kind of fun, you know. For sure.
How many people are in the stream right now?
I don't know, maybe one or something.
18.
On my.
Like 18.
That's in the normal stream, like
yeah.
No, personal. It's cool.
I guess it's time to sign up as a mercenary.
Are you allowed to do that?
I don't know, maybe it's not allowed.
Quick way to the top, I like it.
Maybe. I'm not sure if people that are... I think people that are KO'd can merc, yeah.
Yeah. All I can do is play Assault, but...
Pretty aggressively at that.
Yeah, and I think it bites me in the ass sometimes.
Just spend until the next tournament just like secretly learning how to play Recon. And then come into it and be like, oh yeah, I'm gonna have to play Recon because we've got too many Assault players. Oh no, we're gonna lose. And then just fucking... beast on him.
Nah, I'd probably go support. I can't recon very well.
Anyway.
Oh, by the way, I want to dedicate this win to Dan M. on the gear, boys.
Aim locking the ghost through the wall.
Okay.
Yeah,
well, I want to extend my thanks to Son of Uzu for streaming. And thank you for both teams for the great match. I also appreciate the people that host the server, in this case Mugi and Servo, thanks for doing so.
Yeah.
Very kind.
Watching everyone, it makes me feel better about my pathetic life.
I wish the tournaments happened more.
I mean, at least we have demonstrated that the tournament can get quite heated towards the end. I'm sorry if my commentating was very boring. I tried my best there. It was very
It's really hard to
slow.
Keep up casting NT because it happens all happens
yeah,
at the same time.
I mean, it started very slowly. I was running out of words there, but then towards the end, it started really building up and it was coming back to me.
I look forward to watching the bot.
Yeah, same.
It's going to be quite flaccid at the start, for at least casting wise. And yeah, other than that, I think we concluded most of the information that has been. You know, going back and forth, people exchanged their thoughts, we saw the game. There was the classical hiccup at the start, was, you know, the teams and shit. Good times.
Yes. Good times. Very good game. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
With that, I think we can conclude the stream. Thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you in the next match.